So I was like crawling through, trying not to put my knees in water because literally there was like pipes that I had to go under and stuff like that.
Today I am at a customer's home with Mike, and he is inside the house right now checking out the indoor portion of the air conditioner. They called us because the air conditioner just isn't working at all. So when he first gets here, he's gonna check out the thermostat and then go down and look at the coil in the furnace area, make sure that it's not freezing. And then when he comes back out, we will watch what he does with the outside unit here, see what's going on with it.
Yeah.
You said it's a block of ice?
Yeah, line set's a block of ice.
One out there.
Yeah, I'll just pull the filter so that's not blocking airflow if that is the issue. Typically with the line freezing up like this, one of two things: lack of airflow or lack of refrigerant. So it's either it can't breathe, can't deliver the air that it's supposed to and starts freezing up, or if it develops a leak or needs maintenance, then that refrigerant line will start freezing up as well. So usually those are the two main causes of it happening, but pulling the air filter, if I can get it out, will help more air move. I'm getting too old to get in these spaces.
I'm just gonna go ahead and let you get down there, and I'll take your word. I'll take your word for what's going on. The furnace is down there?
Yeah.
Oh my.
I'd say that's probably the root of your problem.
Yeah, your coil's a huge block of ice down there. Good news is, it's only 5 years old. So more than likely, it's just an airflow issue.
So I'll probably have to get a filter.
The ice there, we really can't do anything to help that process, but run that fan to try to melt that ice faster. Out here, it's gonna melt faster because it is hotter.
Yeah.
But leaving that fan running that fastest speed in the cooling mode will help melt that ice, that block of ice that's down there on the evaporator coil, faster at least. But I guess you have probably 2 to 3 hours of melting before, I mean, it's bad down there. So that style filter, they recommend changing it out once a month. That's pretty bad. I mean, you could tell the difference in the what it looked like brand new and what it looks like now. So, and you said, how long have you been here?
Been here about a
year.
Yeah.
And you hadn't changed the filter yet. So that's at least
who knows if they changed it before they left.
Yeah, so that's at least a year of dirt buildup on that.
Yeah, it looks like it's a 2015 model, so it's 6 years old. We got on a efficient air conditioner. It looks like they got you a 16th here, which is a efficient. But yeah, I would just continue the running of the blower and leaving the thermostat the way that it sets up, melts it faster, all right? And eventually it'll get to the point where you'll feel more room temperature air moving throughout the vents. Right now, you probably don't feel anything because it's a block of ice down there. Basically, we're just giving it a few hours of thaw. Evaporator coil was frozen, line set was frozen. When that happens, we can't check refrigerant charge, we can't check anything really, the operation of the system until it's thawed out. So we're gonna give it a few hours, leave the blower going, and then we'll come back later on and check things out to see if it is a airflow issue or if it's a refrigerant issue. Filter was extremely dirty, so more than likely it's an airflow issue, but we'll see later on when we do the follow-up. Now they called this out, they just said that it wasn't cooling, and when it freezes up like it is, and a block of ice, then it's not pushing any air through that block of ice, so it's not even moving around room temperature air. It's not moving around any air at all. It's just frozen. So and you know, it'd be different if it was a little bit frozen and it's still moving some air around, but this is a block of ice, so it wasn't moving any throughout the house at all. So it's over 80 degrees outside. It's just hot and stale and muggy inside. Number one reason that system breaks down is lack of maintenance. So